Hallelujah. Somebody just lift up your hands and begin to worship the name of the Lord. All over this room. All over this room, just lift up your voice and give him all the praise. Give him all the worship because he deserves the worship. He deserves to be adored. Father, we welcome your presence in this place. Holy Spirit, come and have your way. Lord, be enthroned, oh God. Lord, rise on the wings of our praises, Yahweh. And be exalted, oh God. And be magnified, oh God. And be lifted up, oh God. Holy Spirit, have your way. Father, we honor you. Father, we give you the place of honor in this place. Be enthroned, hallelujah, as we sing, as we pour our hearts, oh God, in worship. Hallelujah. Hosanna in the highest. Let our King be lifted high. Hosanna. Come on, help me sing Hosanna.
Hosanna.
We sing.
Higher, higher.
hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Clap your hands, all you people. Clap your hands, all you people. Rejoice, 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 rejoice. Rejoice, 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 rejoice. Jam your hands together to the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Has the Lord been good to you?
Yes.
Has the Lord been good to you?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. He's been good to us. So we're going to praise God this morning. We're going to give thanks to the Lord for great things that he has done. This is what I'm about to do right now. Just say, oh, give thanks to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For great things that he has done. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord for great things he has done. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for great things he has done. You just say, thank you. Great things in your sight.
gonna call his name Jehovah. Do you remember that one?
Yes.
You remember the one?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Yahweh, you are good. Mighty God.
Mighty God.
Yahweh, you are good.
Mighty God. Mighty God.
Yahweh, you are good.
Mighty God. Mighty God.
Jehovah.
Jehovah is your name.
Yahweh, you are good.
Mighty God.
Mighty God. Yahweh, you are good.
Mighty God.
Yahweh, you are good.
Mighty God. Mighty God.
Jehovah.
Spirit. The Bible says those who will worship me in truth and in spirit. All
all we just need in this service, connect our mind to God. Tell somebody by your side, forget about that situation. God is in charge of it. Please help me preach to somebody beside you. Say, forget about that situation. My Jesus is in charge of it. He's in charge. 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 If you believe with me, jam your hands together. Shout hallelujah. You may be seated. God bless you. Hallelujah. It's so beautiful to be with you this morning. To praise God with you this morning. Hallelujah. So excited. Every minute of my life that I have opportunity to praise God, I just do it like that's the last opportunity that I have. I just do it. But the more I do it, the more He blesses me. The more I do it, it saves me. The more I do it, it just paths my way for me. Amen. So I do it. I lavish it. I just give it to God. Amen. So if you do the same all the time, you know, it's just a few minutes. We have all the time to ourselves. Most of the time, we'll go shopping, we'll go to work, we'll talk to friends. We can talk to friends for hours. But when it comes to worship, the devil just come and like, oh, it's getting too much. It's not too much for my God. That's the only thing that when you give to Him, He will come near you. Like the Bible says that He inhabits the praise of His people. That's the only thing where you're giving, He will just come near you and He will just be running around you, behaving like a child all around you. So that moment, that is the best time to just give your hearts to the Lord. Put your hands together and shout, praise the Lord, somebody! Amen. Amen! Yes, choir, thank you. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. Oh, no, no, no. Let's do that song. I belong to you. Hallelujah. I want to do a song with the choir this morning that says, all the glory belongs to you. You say, you pulled me out of the miry clay. You set my feet on higher ground. All the glory belongs to God. You are the Lord, Most High God. All the glory belongs to you. You reign, you rule. Oh,
glory of God. Just begin to connect to Him, even where you are, in your own way, in your own style. All the power, all the glory belongs to Him. He is the glory and the lifter of our head. You know, I want us to worship God with an understanding this morning. You know, many a times when we come for meetings like this, personally, one thing I like about this kind of meeting is we are not coming to hear any man. It's you connecting with God. Because you know where it pinches you. You know where it hurts. You know where you feel the pain. You know, sometimes you might be going through things you can't even say to your spouse. You can't even explain it. But we have a God who, the Bible says, we don't serve an high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities. He understands us. He knows. And he doesn't just know. He can do far exceedingly above that we can even ask or think. You know, sometimes when we come to Him, we have requests, we have concerns, and we are saying, oh God, when are you going to do this? When are you going to do that? I've heard a true life story of someone who went into surgery. He had a bad right knee, and they needed to amputate somehow. For some reason, there was some mix-up, and they ended up having to cut the good leg. And by the time they discovered their mistake, they still needed to cut the right leg anyway. And at the end of the day, this was someone who went in and came out with both legs already gone off. He didn't do anything wrong. I heard of another person who just went for, they call it bunion surgery or whatever. It's just something very, very minor, just for them to just cut and clip, and that's it. Somehow she bled on the table, and the bleeding refused to stop, and she just went. So most times when we sit down and we take some things for granted and we think, oh, they are so good, they are professional, they are this, they are that, forgetting the fact that it is God. It has nothing to do with being professional. It has nothing to even being in Europe, so to speak. There are so many surgeries we hear gone wrong, even in here in the United Kingdom. So I don't know which thing you've gone through. You had to travel. All of a sudden, you take it for granted. Oh, I came because I paid for my flight. No, it's because God kept you. Why not just begin to just bless God? Just begin to thank Him. Don't even ask Him for anything. Just begin to thank Him. You slept, you woke up this morning. You didn't go past some crazy people. We hear a lot of crazy things on the news. Your children went to school, they came back. God has kept them, God has been with them. You are not with them all the time. God has been looking after them, protecting them. Why not just give Him thanks? You know, this service is just to just come and say, God, we thank you. God, we bless your name. We're not taking any of these miracles. We're not taking it for granted. We're not taking it for granted. It's not even because we're even righteous. The Bible says our righteousness, even before Him, they're like filthy rags. We're not even coming with Him with a sense of entitlement. We're just hanging on His mercy. Why not just bless Him? Just bless Him. Just bless Him. Just bless Him. Just bless Him. Just bless Him on behalf of your family, on behalf of your loved ones, far and near. The Bible says as good news is to his thirsty soul, as water is to his thirsty soul, so is good news even from a far country. Every time you help your loved ones far and near, thank him for good news. Father, we give you praise. 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 Father, we bless your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So can you just play on the piano, please? Hallelujah. Amen. Sister Tolani, please, can you just come forward, please? Hallelujah. I want us to just begin. Just begin to just bless the Lord. Just bless him. Father, we give you praise, oh God. And Brother Steve, please, just join your wife. Join your wife. Just come. Just come. My little shkefa. Just stand here. My little shkefa. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Just hold each other's hands. Amen. Just keep praying in the spirit. Just pray in the spirit. Father, we bless your holy name. Lord, we give you praise, oh God. My hand of the worship to behind. My life behind. My life is good for her. Lay your little boy behind. Lay your little boy behind. Mali de ba hey ele de bo mali de ba etele de ba Lord we give you praise glory to your name O God Lord mali ba hey etele bo Lord we bless your name O God hey ele de bo hey ele de bo ba ha ele de bo we give you glory Lord oh we
you are.
worship you forever. One of the things which God said to me, even at a very early stage, was that he was going to send some people this way, people who he has actually even ordained himself, you know, even ordained even to ministry. And one of the questions I kept asking myself was, we are still a very small church, you know, but so many things have confirmed it, such that God has brought some people who I very much understand that God has prepared them himself, and he's still very much preparing them even for greater works. When we're worshiping, the Lord just said to me that he wants to anoint some people specially for ministry. Sometimes it's not a thing which a pastor likes to do lightly, because you look at it that you want to, you know, you want to like have everybody under you grow and sit on them and feel fat. But the whole thing is about the kingdom, it's about God. And if there is anything I've always said in this house, is that God can raise anyone to be the pastor of this assembly. And God is waiting on you to also come into position, because this pulpit is for God himself. It's not, and I keep saying it, I try to make it as a joke that this is the Redeemed Christian Church of God and not the Redeemed Christian Church of Nimsi. But the fact is that there is a calling of God, a special calling of God on your life. God is just showing me some strange things about some of us. You might be wondering that. I'm not saying you should come and become a pastor tomorrow morning. But there is a unique grace, a unique ministry which God has entrusted into your hands. So even as you are in your position where you are this morning, just worship God, and the Lord is going to drop a mantle. He will start giving you instructions. He will start giving you work. He will start telling you things. He will start showing you things, doing some things which he wants to do, even through your life. Hallelujah. Just bless him. Just worship him. He said he's going to anoint people all around, all over this auditorium this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Song, please, and immortal, invisible God only wise. Yeah, with the piano. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. Most glorious, delicious.
Most glorious.
I'll bring the
sing with me alive. He's my God.
Oh,
our special guest this morning, Pastor Pat. God bless you very much, man. Thank you very, very much. Amen. You know, personally, I really cherish relationship, you know, and for relationship that is with us. I mean, that she is with us this morning. I mean, trust me, if you really have to do the needful, we need to pray and fast. But thank God for, she has a heart for God, she has a heart for ministry, and she obliged us. Thank you very much. God bless you. Amen. And our love to the bishop. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Please, if you're watching with us for the first time, we just want to just celebrate you. We just wanted to just love our God. We should have welcomed you before now, but sorry. You know, but yeah, just hallelujah. Please, if you're sitting beside them, please just make them feel welcome. Just give them his royal house special hug. We love you. God bless you real good. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 You know, his royal house is one of the many redeemed Christian church parishes in the United Kingdom. In this assembly, we say we are a people of praise with a royal heritage. Hallelujah. So peradventure you're living around and God is directing you our way. This place is strong enough and big enough to minister to your needs. Hallelujah. And I pray the Lord will bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. Amen. I can see one of our bishops at the back there, Pastor Roy. I celebrate you, sir. Amen. Welcome. Celebration for you, sir. I can see Reverend Nii as well. More anointing, sir. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Please, after the service, please don't rush up. We have a little reception for you after service. So we just a little bite and just want to shake your hand. We want to know you some more. Hallelujah. Pastor, I can see, there's one of our sister here in front as well. Please, let me welcome her very well. She's Sister Shade. I know she's hiding. I know she's a member of the family. So please, let's celebrate her. Make her feel welcome. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We are still going to just worship God for another few minutes before we now come and just round up the service. You know, I always say something called the last dance. The last dance is just beautiful. Peradventure, you've not connected until now. Forget about protocol. Pull your jacket if you need to. You know, just let it loose for God. Please, let's celebrate one more time. Pastor, Bishop, Minister, Pat. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Amen.
Glory.
I just love to praise God. I don't know about you. When I do that, I'm just in my... it's just like giving a little child... what's the best thing they like? Something like that, you know. Yeah, and all that. Amen. Praise God. Who wants to remember this song? I'll begin the praise even before you answer. I'll ask for nothing, just begin to worship. But now I know I join the overflow. Baba God, you are faithful. Now I know you are faithful.
Now I know
you are faithful.
The praise,
even before you answer, I'm fine.
Bless you more, more, more. Amen. You want to give God more, more, more. Jesus will bless you more, 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 more. Amen. Hallelujah. We didn't walk around this, so every one of us, we're just going to learn it. I remember what Jesus did for me, and that's where that song came from. It's done me well. Something happened some time ago, and God said to me, you know, through men of God, that he was going to do it. And I was still thinking in my mind, is it going to be possible? Is it? Okay, that's what he says. But one day, I was just in my room, just, you know, very early in the morning, about 20 minutes to 7. And I just, somebody just tapped me. I looked around. Somebody here. I slept this way again. And that same thing tapped me, and I just woke up. He said, hey, babe. It became a drama in my spirit, man. He was like, I told you before, and I'm saying it again to you. Not from any man of God, not from any. I'm saying it to you, I'm going to bless you. I'm going to surprise you, and it's soon. So at that time, I knew the Holy Spirit was around ministering to me, because I woke up like 5. I couldn't sleep. I was just stunning. But by 7, the Holy Spirit came. He said, hey, babe, I'm going to do it for you. What was that thing that I was looking for? I lost my son, my very first son. And at that time, there was nobody, no child around me, no baby around me. So every time I go ministering and I come back, and I just feel very empty. I just go, I come back, everybody rejoice, everybody's excited, they are all gone. But I go back to my room and it becomes like a dark room, you know. So every time I just ponder, I just go round and round all by myself. But by this day, till 7 in the morning, he came to me by himself. He said, hey babe, I'm gonna do it for you, and it's very soon. And that got my spirit lifted. I was excited. And when I saw that, okay, I knew the person that was in my around me. He now said to me, so if I do it for you, what are you going to do? And that time, laughter came. I was very excited in my spirit, because I knew that was the Spirit of God ministering to me, straight as in direct, not man of God telling me anything, Spirit of God saying. So I was excited in my spirit, and almost immediately, I said, I don't know how to do any other thing. The only thing I know I would do is I'll just let the old one know that you have done it for me. That you have done me well. He said, oh babe, so go ahead and do it right now. I said, the first thing that came to my spirit, man, you know, like an artist, I just said, nobody can do me like you do. Nobody can bless me like you do. He's done me well. I feel you everywhere I go. You've really turned my life around. He's done me well. You turned my morning into dance. I'll forever live to testify. He's done me well. I'll go again. Nobody can do me like I do. Nobody can bless me like I do. He's done me well. Yeah. I feel you everywhere I go.
Oh,
called the producer. I said, I'm coming to do a song just for me and my God, because there's a deal. He told me he was going to do it. So this is the song when he has done it. Amen. So I did the song. Then inside my house, I just run around. It's up and down. So when I'm just going, I'll keep playing the song. And I keep running around in my house. That was the deal between me and him. And he did it anyway. Amen. It doesn't matter what people are saying. It's not about the time. When you do what he wants you to do, in fact, it's faster. Why you only wait for what he has said? Because he said it 2,000 years ago. Like he said, like if he says you're healed, yes. But you have to play a role believing, trusting, and standing there. Not when someone come and say, oh, he has not done it. Say, hey, never do more. Eh? I don't understand though. You have to understand. It's a deal. It's something he has sealed with you. You have to stand there. Confess it day by day, pronounce it day by day, tell it to someone. When my husband came back, I said, God said he was going to do it. He was just excited because I'm happy anyway. And I said, oh, really? Wow, great, 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 great. You know, but it was too strong on me and I believed it. So since then, all by myself, I just run around. Just believing. A blessing unto you, beautiful week for you, and that very thing you're waiting God on, God is going to do it, and your song will be, He has done me well. God bless you. Thank you. Hallelujah. If you're giving it up for Jesus, if you're giving it up for the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the one who has done it. Bible says, say the things that are not as though they were. Do you believe it? He is able. The one who is more than able. I'm not hearing your glory to him. I'm not hearing. He has given you those hands. Clap unto the King of Kings. The Lord of Lords. The Almighty God. The one who was, who is, and is to come. Father, we worship you for an awesome time in your presence. Hallelujah. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Please let's have our seat just for a minute as we run the service. My God, I don't know about you. I think I am fed up. As in, I am full and overflowing. Hallelujah. Amen. Awesome time worshiping God today. Has it been an awesome time in the presence of the Lord? Hallelujah. Once again, we are His Royal House, a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, one of the many parishes worldwide. And I know the Lord is doing something wonderful in our midst. We are a people of royal heritage and we are a people of praise. Hallelujah. Once again, I just want to celebrate each and every one of you for coming here today. Please mark today's date. Because a testimony or testimonies are birthed already in the name of Jesus. We meet here every 10 o'clock, every Sunday, by the grace of God, in the name of Jesus. Please invite someone next Sunday. Tell them. I know you've experienced something here today. We don't want to be selfish. Spread it and invite somebody next Sunday. The Lord bless you. Let's rise on our feet as we share the grace and fellowship. But before we go, I want you to look at a handsome person next to you, a gorgeous lady next to you. Say to them, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Turn to somebody else. Say, surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Say to 1,000 people, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Now say to yourself, declare, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Father, we just thank you. We bless your holy name. As we go in your power, in your strength, in your favor, in your peace, in your love. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. You have a blessed week.